Okay, are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, I can
Fine.
see the screen, yeah.
Okay, so basically today we started our first module, which is the introduction to cybersecurity. After that, we do the practicals and all these things we will learn. So in the
Okay.
first one module, first thing is that one, what is cybersecurity? So tell me one by one if you have any idea about that one. After that, I will explain you.
Yeah, we have idea of cyber security.
What's the function we have to perform in the cyber security? Why we are using the cyber security?
No, cyber security in any organization to secure the network, okay? There should not be any hack, and for that purpose, generally, cyber security is required for any organization.
Yeah, basically for that one, we know that cyber security is we are using to secure our devices, like any device, which is the mobile devices, servers or computers, anything from the malicious
Computer.
attack. Okay.
Yeah. Right.
So in
Right.
that one case, we have to know that what there are different types of cyber, different types of security are present in our network. So number one is the network security. Number second is the application security. Third one is the information. And fourth one is the operational. In that one, we have to know that what type
Right.
of security it is. So basically, in the network security, you have to focus on the targeters. Like if any type of malicious attack is performing in your website or suppose in your network, so you have to know that what type of attack will be there. So with the help of VPNs, you can say that, or second one is the firewall, because firewall play a major role because it contains a defender. Basically, firewall is that one, like it is allow or deny some network, and both
Right.
and
Yeah.
ongoing and the outgoing network. If there is a
Yeah.
firewall contains like this content, particularly is the malicious, so it can block them, otherwise it can pass them out. So in the
Pass
network
them,
security, you have to focus on the firewall or the VPN. VPN is the virtual private network. Okay.
Yeah,
For
virtual
example,
private
yeah.
network. Yeah.
For example, if you want to connect to some other country or some other places for opening some websites, so you have to use the VPN because it can change your IP address.
Yeah.
Okay. Next is that one is the application security. In the application security, you have to focus on the softwares or some apps which is present in the mobile phone. So you have to make sure of the designs and all the security bringings present in that one particular apps. So this one comes under the application security. Third is the informational security. Information security basically depends upon the data, like what data you have to transmit or what data you have to be stored. So it depends upon that one. Last is the operational security. In the operational
Right.
security, you have to focus on the processes, like what process do you have to follow to sending your data from source destination and source to the destination IP. Basically, in the case of ethical
Destination, yeah.
hacking or in the cyber security, you have to mainly focus on the IP address, because IP address is the must thing. But how can you transfer
Right.
and how can you focus on
Right.
this one? So here is the network security protection, which I already told you,
Right.
like network security protection contains the firewalls and the remote access VPNs. VPNs I've already also we are
Firewall.
using in the different type
Yeah.
of topics, like in the mobile hacking or in the system hacking, we are using the VPNs. That is open VPN, which we want to connect with the different IP person, which is not present in our range. Next is what are the cyber threats. So basically, cyber security are their threats controlled in the three folds. First one is the cyber crime. Cyber crime is that one in this only the not only the single actor is present. In that one, the group of person are present to attack on the particular website, particular server or particular company for their financial gain. Second is
Yeah.
the cyber attack. Cyber attack potentially motivated information gathering. That means information gathering particular about the particular person or any particular company. This comes under the cyber attack. Third is the cyber terrorism. That means you make a particular panic or the fear in the person's mind. Like suppose there are various types of cyber attacks are present and every person thought that this is the panic or the fear. So this comes under the cyber terrorism.
Okay.
Now, this is about the certificates in the ethical hacking. So these are all are the certificates which is present in the cybersecurity ranging form. But mainly you have to focus on the first one, which is the cybersecurity, that is the certified ethical hacking certification. This is the very prior or the first certificate which you got after doing the this one course.
This course.
Yeah. Okay. After that one course, you have to particularly purchase the voucher for that one, like the certified ethical hacking. And this course contains about that one. Yeah, this exams contain around the 4 hours. Okay, 4 hours exam. This will be conducted, and if you want, so you can purchase the voucher. After that, you got the certificate for the certified ethical hacking. After that, suppose you want to do like, okay, we done the ethical hacking and you want to switch for the web penetration testing. That is the bug bounty course. I think you can hear about that one. So
yeah,
after that,
bounty,
yeah, bug bounty. In the bug bounty, you got this one, penetration tester, because the ethical hacker is also known as the penetration tester. So if you want that one, so after that, this certificate will be provided to you, and all the certificate related to the this one networking part. CISSP, CISSP.
What will be the duration of the penetration tester, that course?
Basically, penetration tester is the higher course related to the ethical hacking. Suppose you are completed your ethical hacking in the 30 days, max to max. Suppose, so penetration testing will take around the 40 days because it can contains the 30 topics. And all the particular test is not be completed in the 1 day. So you can be continue about that 45 days, max to max, 45 to 60 days. Your penetration testing has to be complete. But penetration testing is the, you can say that the more higher version for the, beside the ethical hacking, because in that one, you have to find out the different type of vulnerabilities, like the command injection, XSS attack.
SQL injection.
Yeah, SQL injection. Yeah. SQL injection will perform in this one, ethical hacking, but with the help of tools.
Ethical.
Yeah. But in the case of the penetration testing, we do the manually SQL injection.
Okay.
Now next is the what is basically ethical hacking. So in the ethical hacking, you have to learn about that. You have to gain the unauthorized access on the computer. That means that person has to be no idea that you are hacking his system. Okay. But in the case of ethical hacking, you do the attack on the particular system, but in that one manner, like for only the security purpose. Yeah. For the security purpose, not for only the financial gain. But in the case of ethical hacking, there are three types of hackers are present. But firstly, we focus on the roles. So basically, ethical hacker has four major roles, like this one, which is present on the screen. Like ethical hacker do the authorization on the particular website or particular system. Second one, it do the assessments of all the systems. Third, all it can reports and all the security breaches. Like suppose I have a website and you do attack on my websites. In any manner. So suppose is there any vulnerabilities or anything which is present in my website, so you come to me and report that one vulnerability. Like suppose, okay, this part is your creating someone, suppose to find that there is a vulnerabilities in the website. So that is your work, because you are the ethical hacker or the penetration tester. But at some time, suppose you are using that one vulnerabilities as your own financial gain or anything other purpose, so you are the black hat hacker, not the white hat hackers.
Black hacker. Yeah.
And on this basis, there are various different types of hackers are present. Black hat hackers, white hat, gray hat, red, purple, green, blue. But we have to mainly focus on the only three types of hackers, which is the black, white,
three
and gray.
Types, yeah.
Okay, because these are the three hackers which are most importantly present in our whole networks. So the black hat hacker is that one who is known as the unethical hacker, or you can say that the security cracker, because its mainly purpose only to stealing the money or achieving their illegal goals. Like suppose your bank card details or any debit card, credit card, all the information it can do be only the hack. Okay, all destroy things and so that's why we can call the black hat hacking is the illegal hacking. Next is the white hat hacker, which you and me people are, because we are the penetration tester. We are the good guys. We are using the same technique as that of the black hat hackers, but only in order to testing the security systems or protecting our IT systems. That's why white hat hacker is the illegal. Sorry, it's legal.
Legal.
Next is the gray hat hacker. Gray hat hackers is nothing but it is the hybrid of both black hat and the white hat.
Yeah.
It cannot do the systems only for the hacking purpose or not for the stealing. It can depends upon their own mood type. Like suppose any gray hat hacker stealing the credit card information or any other information, that means this comes under the black hat. If they do only the systems for the security, so it comes under the white hat. So basically it is a hybrid. You cannot say that this is illegal or the legal part. It just depends upon the activities which white hat hacker performs. Okay, and after that is a
Okay.
Red Hat hacker. Red Hat hacker is basically focused on the only the Red Hat system, that is the Linux operating system. So that's why it is known as the Red Hat hackers. But these are not as much as important as that of three, which is black, white, and gray. Blue Hat is hackers is known as the security professional related to the Microsoft company, because on the blue color represent to the Microsoft basically, and Blue Hat hackers are very world famous for due to the Microsoft only. Purple Hat hackers are that one who has very basic things, like suppose only be working on their own PCs to checking that this is the hacking or not, because it is the fresh guy. Same as that of the green. Green is also the fresh in the hacking world. Like suppose I am joining some courses and do the hacking on my system. So that's why this is the green hat hackers. Now the next thing is that one, CMDs and the Linux commands, because we are focusing on both system, both operating system. We have to focus on the Windows also or the Linux also. So we have to focus on both. So for that one,
Linux will be
Kali
Linux,
Linux.
That is Kali Linux.
Yeah, Kali
okay.
Linux. So we have to install our VirtualBox in the system. After that, we have to install the Kali. So both of your system VirtualBox is present either, or we have to download.
Today, tomorrow we'll do that one better.
No problem.
Today,
are you both connected with your laptop or the mobile phone?
No, laptop.
Okay, so one by one you can share the screen, and we are installing a particular virtual box, and tomorrow we will do the commands in your system. Okay, 1 minute.
Yeah,
fine, I give you the permission now. So firstly, installing done. Okay, now anyone, firstly share the screen. I will help you to download.
Oh, okay, downloading is fine. Better we'll do tomorrow this one, because our laptop not that much memory. Memory, at least it should be, I think, 8 GB or more than 8, I think.
No,
so,
nothing more. 4 GB is the enough for the ethical hacking course.
4 GB is enough?
Yeah, 4 GB.
Ah, okay, 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 no problem. Okay, okay, then fine. Tomorrow we have plan. Okay, then from tomorrow we'll sit together, and we have plan to make one high configure PC.
We will make other system than we'll install.
Other system, yeah, that is our plan.
So you
but anyhow,
practice in one system.
Anyhow, means one system, we have other system also, but today I came home, but from tomorrow we'll do from office. Okay, we'll work, we'll study in office.
Okay.
So
but yeah, make sure you can okay, in the tomorrow class I will help you to download. Okay, no problem.
Yeah, that will be better, I think. Yeah.
Okay, so this is all about our CMD commands. Like suppose we have to follow the commands in the CMD. So firstly, we have to search on the CMD, and suppose because a command line is very important in the case of ethical hacking, because we do the all the practicals in our Kali Linux. So in the Kali Linux, all are the not on the GUI base.
Yeah.
It is a CLI base, so we have to focus on the command.
Yeah, right.
So suppose you want to check any type of directory in the CMD, so you have to type here the command dir. Dir represents the directory. After pressing entry, all the directories present inside the Disha, because I am in the C users in Disha. So here all the directories are present. Suppose we want to switch our directory. Like suppose I want to go to the desktop. So what command I used? I use cd space change directory, and I have to write the name. Enter
desktop.
Okay, now suppose another thing, I again check my directory, so I place the dir. Okay. Next thing, suppose I want to check my IP address, so here I have to use the ip config, but in the Kali Linux I have to use the command if config. Sometimes there is a difference. So this is our my IP. Okay. Next thing, suppose I want to check my host name, that what host name I belongs to you, so I write the command host name.
Host name.
It give me the host name.
Fine.
Okay, next command is that one, suppose I want to change the color of some this one written form, so I write the color and any color coding. It give you the help code. Here is shows me the help coding, like what type of color we want. So again write the color and any code which I want, like suppose light yellow, so I light purple. D, enter. It change the color. Okay.
Okay,
now suppose you want to open the another type of another command prompt without closing this one, so you have to write the command start. After starting, there is another command prompt is open. Okay, if you want to close that one, so you have to use the command exit. After
exit.
That previous one is closed, anyone you can to be open. Okay, there are almost 20 commands are presented here. One by one, you can use everything. Like suppose if you want to see the date, so you have to write the date. It shows you the date. If you want to change the date, you can write another date here and after pressing enter. Same as that for the time. Okay, next command is for that one. Like suppose you want to ping your system. Like suppose ping is the command which you want to check that you are present in the network or not. So you have to use the ping. Yeah. Suppose I use google.com here. It will be pinging. Okay, that means yes, you are receiving your packets from one point to the another.
Packets, yeah.
Okay, anything if you want to use the trace router, anything, there are different type of commands which I presented here. Like suppose you want to make the directory. Okay, on the desktop, there is no directory is present in the desktop with my name. So suppose the command is mkdir, which is used as a make directory.
Mkdir.
Okay, Disha, enter. You see that Disha directory is presented here. If you want to delete this one, so you have to use the rmdir, which is the remove directory.
Remove
enter,
it.
Can remove it. Okay, so in my PPT, after the class, I will send it to you, no problem. In that one, there are 20 commands are present, so you can be one by one using that one command. Now, the next thing is that one, why I'm using the Linux in the ethical hacking? This is the question. Okay, why we are not using the this one, Windows, for the ethical hacking? So can you please tell me what the particular reason for that one? In the meantime, I start my Kali. Yes, tell me why we are using the Linux.
That command base, right? That.
Any idea?
That's the thing. Windows, no idea.
Linux is more secure, right, than Windows. That's why.
Yeah, like, basically, yeah, more secure. But on what basis it is secure?
Mainly, Windows, there is chance for virus affection. It will be.
No, actually, that is GUI. This is a command base. Maybe that is it is difficult to.
Command base is also the Linux. No, that one person. Sorry, that thing. That he said.
Only
more secure in the case of the virus.
You are, yeah.
Yeah, because in the Windows, most of the viruses are run in the Windows. Okay, but not on the Linux. That's why we are using prefer Linux for the ethical hacking. Okay, and also it is very fast for the secure, but for the Windows, we have to paid, like for using the, but Linux, we have to be installed without any cost. So that's why we are using the Linux.
Yeah, without any cost also. Yeah. So especially why we use Kali Linux for this ethical hacking for and...
For the purpose of the viruses, because in that one, we have to create the viruses and executing. So that's why we are using the Linux. But in the Windows, all the viruses are... before previously run, but in the Linux there is no virus effect. That's why we are using the Kali Linux.
So we can use only Kali Linux. There is many other Linuxes, right? Like Red Hat Linux. So
you can use any. You can use any type of Linux because at some time Parrot OS is also using in the ethical hacking. So if you want, so you can use that one because all the interfaces are sometimes different, but the working are the same. But we are using the Kali in another process. Like suppose Kali contains all the types of and tools which is pre-installed. Like suppose when you click on this one dragon sign, so all the things are already presented here. Only you have to install it and use it. That's why we are mainly focused on the Kali Linux.
Yeah.
Kali Linux, okay.
Now suppose we want to open the terminal, so we have to click in this one black sign. So here we have to use the first command, which is the sudo bash. Sudo bash is the command for taking the administrative power. That means you want to write any type of commands here or anything. So you have to use the sudo bash. Next is you have to write the password. Password is the osboxes.org for my Kali. Enter. Now here is the same thing which we are using in the Windows. Like suppose you want to change the directory. So you have to use the CD. But there you are using the dir for checking the directory. Here you have to use the ls, which is the listing.
Okay.
Okay. So now we have suppose change the directory cd desktop. We are on the desktop.
Desktop.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, if you want to check your IP address, so you have to use the ifconfig. After ifconfig, it gives you the IP address. This is my IP address of the Kali. 192.168.29.247. But when you install your Kali, so it gives you the IP of ranges about 10.0 dot something, because at that particular time it is working on the NAT adapter. Okay, so you have to be shifted into the bridge adapter. Now the question is that one, what is the difference between the NAT and the bridge adapter? So at the time when you connect into the NAT adapter, so it can take the IP of the their region. But if you want to shift it to the bridge adapter, that means you are we want to communicate your Kali with your main window. That's why we are using the bridge adapter. Okay. Because suppose my IP is suppose 10.0 dot something. So it has a different range related to the main system IP, because which is in the range of the 192. So that one is the class C IP, and which is a 10.0, it is the class E IP. So they both not communicate without any router or without anything. So we have to be changing it to the bridge adapter. So that's why they can be communicated with each other. Now suppose any next command is that one same, which suppose you want to make the directory. So you are using the mkdir, and you want to delete the directory. You are using the rmdir. Okay. Now the question is that one, suppose you want to create the file here and wait, I delete this one. Okay. Now, suppose you want to create a particular file and you want to write it there. So you have to use the command touch. Touch is used for create the text file. Okay. Touch, or suppose you are using the same disha.txt, enter. After that, when you're done. Okay. Now, suppose you want to write something in the disha.txt. So you have to use the command nano. Nano is the text editor here. Okay. Nano, leaf pad, mouse pad, anything you can use. But nano is that one you can freely use. But if you want to use the leaf pad, mouse pad, anything, so you have to install that one in your Kali. Okay, it is freely installed, but you have to use some commands to working with that one.
I didn't get that one. What is leaf pad, the mouse pad? Is
leaf pad, so mouse pad, nano, all are the text editor. Like suppose you want to
text edit.
Yeah. That's why you are using.
That is a kind of, that is command, right?
Yeah, command.
Leafpad is command.
Yeah, leafpad is the command, but it is working like same as the notepad which we are using in the Windows.
Okay.
So here is the leafpad. Here, suppose I use the nano, and after that, write here the file name, disha.txt, because I want to write something. Here is the black color screen is to be open. Where you are? Suppose I write here, this is our first class.
Okay, so nano is editor, right?
There is nano is editor. Leaf pad is also the editor. Mouse pad is also the editor. You can use any.
Okay.
It depends upon you.
Saving now, is control D, right?
Yeah. If you want to save this one, firstly you have to use the control O for the write out. After that, press enter, then control X. Three steps you have to take. Control O, enter, control X. Okay, now our file is saved. If you want to again write something in the file or something, you can change. So you have to use the same command. Here you have to write something, and after that add it, then control X. But if you want that, changes in the file, only I have to see the file, that what are the content are present in the file. So you have to write the command cat space file name.
Cat command, yeah.
Yeah.
Enter. Okay.
Yeah.
Now the next thing is that one, suppose you have to move the file. This file is present on the desktop, but you want
cat and the two less sign also you can use, right? For the make the file, right?
Yeah, you
cat can the and cat, sorry, greater sign. Okay.
But suppose if you want to move this file is present on the desktop, but you want that this file move to be the download. So you have to use the full command, like suppose mv for the move, and write the file name, which is the disha.txt. And you have to write the full path name, desktop, like slash home, slash OS boxes, then slash downloads. Enter. There is no error is present, and our file is move now. We have to do the cd space dot dot for the back one step. Here is our downloads is present, so you have to use the downloads, enter. Now ls, When you press ls, you see that disha.txt file is presented here. Clear?
Yeah, clear.
Okay. Now the next is that one. Suppose I again move this one file because I show you the another command here. No? Move this one to the desktop. Okay. Now it is also presented here. Okay. If you want to see that where are you present right now, so you can use the PWD. PWD is the present working directory.
PWD.
We are here is the present working.
Yeah.
LS we are using CD mkdir match and okay, all are done. Yeah. Basically, if you want, if you see that there is a disha.txt with a lock presented here, that means it has only some type of permission is already presented here. Like suppose where is a lock is present. So if you want to remove the lock, suppose, okay, disha contains the lock file. So you have to change the mode. Okay, firstly, we have to go to the desktop. So cd space dot dot and after that, cd space desktop. If you want to clear the screen, so you have to write the clear and enter.
CLS.
Okay. CLS we are using in the Windows. Okay, here is the disha.txt. You have to remove the lock. So firstly, you have to use the change mode, chmod. Okay, chmod is the command for change mode. Change mode, you are
change mode,
basically there are three permission. That is the 421, which is one is for the read, write, execute, or you can say that the owner group and others. Okay,
but first we have to check LTR, right? Minus LTR, that what is the permission there.
Yeah, you can check that one, but I have to see that there is a lock present, so that's why we can
change your.
So here, basically, three permissions are present, like the read, write, and execute. What permission we are giving to this one file? So suppose we are using the 777, that means you are giving the all permission, like the read, write, and the execute. And after that, you have to write the name, disha.txt. Otherwise, if you want to give the permission to the all the things which is present on the desktop, so you have to use the asterisk sign. After that, suppose I press the enter. So you see the lock is removed now. That means you're giving all the power. But sometimes we have some type of issue, like what type of permission I have to be given or something. So you have to use here the change mode calculator. First one is that one. You have to click here. Here is all the permission are given. Like suppose I want that owner has the only the read permission. It has write and it has execute. So here we have to give the 421 permission.
Okay.
Like suppose I want to give all the permissions, so click on everything, it gives you the 777 permission. If you have any doubt or something, so you can choose it from.
That means read means four, right?
Yeah, read, write, and execute is X.
Execute. And what does it mean there? For any file, there is owner, group, and public. What does it mean?
Yeah, owner, group, and public. That means owner, mostly owner has the all the permission. Like suppose I am the owner.
Who makes the file, right?
Makes the file, yes. After that, when you send the file, that person is using, is that the group, something group, you can send the file. Okay, so do you have to mention the in this mode permission? Like suppose when you are using different type of tools in the whole course, so you have to give the change mode permission. Like what permission you have to be given. Like we have to use that one code. Okay, so this is the change mode permission. Next thing is that one, like suppose you want to use some tools which is already present in the Kali. So you are using the command apt-get install and suppose any tool name, because I already told you that Kali contains almost all the tools, but you have to use the tools. So you have to use suppose apt-get install and suppose I want to install the mousepad. Because I don't use that one, no? Mousepad, enter. It starts all these things, done. Okay, that means this is the zero upgraded, zero newly installed, because it is already the pre-installed tool. Only we are using the tool, that's why we are using the command apt-get install mousepad. If you want to use tool, that one, yes?
This tool will be presented in the system or we have to download this package?
No, this is already present in the system. You only write the command to installing that one because it is downloaded now. You have to install it only. After that, you have to write the command mousepad enter. When you press the enter, it opens you that one particular. But here is the fail to execute because it wants the DB launch. Like suppose I am using it. Like suppose I am using the leaf pad. So I use the leaf pad and it opens the same as that of the 1 minute. Leaf pad is installed. APT install leaf pad. It takes some time to installing. After that, suppose this is that one, like suppose Kali using that one tool. It is already the downloaded tool. We have only to use that one. So we are using the apt-install. In the case of Kali, like suppose you want to install the tool which is not present in the Kali. That means you want to install the tools which is from the browser or from the any other place. So in that one, the commands are different. In that one case, you are using the command git clone. Like suppose any other tool. Go to the Kali. Wait. Yeah, now suppose we are using the leafpad. So right here the command leafpad enter. When you enter this one, leafpad is open. Okay, it is working as same as the notepad. You can write anything and save it the file. Now suppose you want to use the tool which is not present in the Kali. So firstly go to here and search for the Firefox. In 6 minutes, okay, the meeting is ended. You have to again join it, okay?
After 6 minutes.
Yeah, after six
Okay.
minutes. Because Zoom has some condition,
Okay,
like
fine.
40 minutes only. Chal. In that
Okay.
one, you have to download the tool. Like, suppose I use the tool, any tool, Paintbox. We have to use the Kali, all the tools which is from the GitHub, okay? So suppose I search here Paintbox and GitHub. Here are different links are to be open here. We have to choose any one. Yes, like suppose I click on this one. Here you have to click on the code. After that, when you click on the code, here is some link is presented here. So you have to copy that one link. So click on this one, copy, and go to terminal back. Here you have to write the command git clone. Git clone is the command which we have to use for downloading any type of tool from the browser or from any other place, not with the Kali. Here you have to be paste something. Make sure you are using the control plus V or control plus C in the Windows for copy and the pasting. But here you have to use plus control shift V or control shift C for downloading or the installing. Okay. When you press enter, it can cloning your paint box. That means it can download your tool from the browser. If I want to use that one, so we have to check here. Now, suppose ls I am using here, you see the paint box is presented on my screen.
This is only for downloading, right? For
Yeah, if we are
downloading from the
downloading
right.
from any type of browser or anything here, so we are using the git clone. If that one tool is already present in the Kali, so you are using the apt-get install. Okay, this is the difference. Here I am giving all the commands here. If you want to use that one, all the 20 commands is already presented here. If you want to use that one, so you can use it easily after the class. Here you have to use same as that of the host name. Like suppose you want to check the host name, when you press enter, it gives you the host name. Okay, if you want to check that what type of file is presented here, so are using the df. Df is the disk file. All the disk file which is present in the Kali all are shown here.
What is difference between DF and DF minus H? H also using, right? DF minus
Like
H.
suppose it is the same as the difference. Like suppose we are using the ls. Okay, ls is the listing commands. If suppose I am using ls hyphen l, so it can also give me the commands. But like
All the details,
all the details, same as that of the disk hyphen l.
Permission,
Yeah, if you want to check that one, so you can easily check
Okay.
that. Okay, these are some commands basically which you have to focus on that one. Like on the Windows also or on the Linux also. So you have to focus on the command. So one by one, when you installing your Kali and all the VirtualBox in your system, so you can be practice for that one also. Okay.
Fine.
Now meeting will be ended in the 3 minutes. So first I ended the meeting and I again started. You can join. So after that we can start the new topic. Okay.
Okay, fine. Okay, thank you.
1 minute I start.